Hey, how's it going, everyone? My name is Zach, and today I'll be working on my Suzuki Samurai. More specifically, today I will be working on my intake manifold. I plan on removing the carburetor from the intake manifold just so that I can clean up the manifold itself. I want to get it all nice and clean and possibly paint it to match the engine block. If you've seen my previous videos, I just finished rebuilding my engine, my 1.3 liter engine. The I painted the valve covers, the valve cover oil pan and pulleys a really nice Chevrolet orange, and I painted the engine block a natural aluminum or metallic color, and it turned out looking really good. And I want to make the intake manifold, I need to clean up the intake manifold so that I can paint it all up to match the natural silver or aluminum look. And I think that it's going to be an easy process to clean it up and paint it. So anyways, let's go ahead and get to it. Just as a closer look to the intake manifold and the carburetor, everything is still intact. But everything needs to come apart. I have hoses, I have electrical cords, I have just a lot of different pieces that need to come, that need to be taken apart. But basically everything from this red gasket here that connects the carburetor to the manifold, I'm going to be taking everything off, setting the carburetor aside for a different day, and then cleaning everything off of the intake manifold. So what I'm going to do to separate these two is, again, just above the red gasket here, you can see that there's a nut here and then a nut here as well. And then on the opposite side, right where my fingers are, there's two more nuts, and I'm going to go ahead and remove those. They require a 12 millimeter wrench, and I'm just going to loosen them up and just take it right off. So what I'd like to show you is that this nut can't come all the way off. This would be on the passenger side, forward face, or the frontmost nut that is holding the carburetor onto the manifold. It can't come off unless if you kind of pull up on the carburetor, and then it'll give you a little bit more room to finish removing the nut. Carburetor has been removed from the intake manifold. And I'm gonna just set that aside for the time being, and I'll come back to that on another day. But I do need to mark off or bag up these nuts so I remember where they came from. On the front side of the manifold, there's this little teeny tiny sensor there. I'm going to go ahead and remove that. This one is a 12 millimeter bolt. Ow. I also just broke it. That is what I get for being rough with it. Now we've got bigger problems. I should have known better than that. Okay, it is time to correct an error that I made while removing this. The sensor that was sitting up here on the front, I put a wrench on it and gave it a good tap with my hand, and it broke clean off. Now, you can see that there's a little bit of a fitting in there, and that's actually brass. And with the fact that it's brass, it is really malleable, and it's going to be really easy to mar up. And I imagine that it's threaded in there, not just pressed in. So I'm going to use an extractor. I'm going to tap it in there nice and easy, and then I'm going to see if I can wrench it out. So I have my intake manifold cleaned up a bit. You can see that there's still quite a bit of debris left on there. I'm going to take my Dremel and a brass wire wheel and try and continue to clean it up a bit. Okay, so I don't remember what the last thing I recorded was, but I am now painting the intake manifold. I plan on matching the color to be the same as the engine. This is a natural, like aluminum or metal color. And I kind of want to do the same thing with the intake manifold. I got some primer and some engine color. So anyway, I have the manifold all taped up. Everything's been taped so that I'm not gonna be spraying into holes and ports and whatnot. So anyways, I'm gonna go ahead and just start painting. Follow your heart and nothing else. Well, the primer on this intake manifold is set really well. I came out and primered it yesterday, and it just went on perfectly fine. Looks like it's dried up, and it looks like I got all the nooks and crannies the best that I could, and I like it. That primer is really going to help the silver color pop really well. So that's what I'm going to do today, is I'm going to go ahead and paint this up with the natural aluminum color. My goats are trying to figure out what I'm doing. Get out of here, this is my shed. Go.
Well, I left Kentucky back in 49 and went to Detroit working on assembly line. The first year they had me putting wheels on Cadillacs. Every day I'd watch them beauties roll by, and sometimes I'd hang my head and cry, 'cause I always wanted me one that was long and black. One day I devised myself a plan that should be the envy of most any man. I'd sneak it out of there in a lunchbox in my hand. Now, getting caught meant getting fired, but I figured I'd have it all.
So here's the intake manifold now that I have all the tape off. I think it looks really good. I don't think that it was the best paint job that I've done, but I think that it definitely looks good when you compare it to the block itself. I just feel like the block came out a lot smoother. And again, like I said, it could just be the fact that there's a bit of a texture on the intake manifold. But it looks good regardless, and I'm pretty happy with it. So I need to take this back off and start adding on some more pieces.
By the time I retired, I'd have me a car worth at least $100,000. I'd get it one piece at a time, and it wouldn't cost me a dime. You'll know it's me when I come through your town. I'm gonna ride around in style, I'm gonna drive everybody wild, 'cause I'll have the only one there is. The very next day when I punched in with my big lunchbox and with help from my friend, I left that day with a lunchbox full of gears. I've never considered myself a thief, but GM wouldn't miss just one little piece, especially if I strung it out over several years. The first day I got me a fuel pump, and the next day I got me an engine and a trunk, then I got me a transmission and all the chrome. The little things I could get in my big lunchbox, like nuts and bolts and all four shocks, but the big stuff we snuck out my buddy's mobile home. Now up to now my plan went all right, till we tried to put it all together one night, and that's when we noticed that something was definitely wrong. The transmission was a 53 and the motor turned out to be a 73, and when we tried to put in the bolts all the holes were gone. So we drilled it out so that it would fit, and with a little bit of help from an adapter kit, we had that engine running just like a song. Now the headlights, there was another sight. We had two on the left and one on the right.
So I want to be extra cautious when tightening this. You really want to feel
the amount of pressure. As soon as it starts getting too hard to turn, I mean, even in the slightest, just stop turning. I'm gonna be happy with that. I'll leave it like that. It does look like it has a little bit of stick out, but it feels a little tight, and I don't want to break it. It's a brand new part. If you are interested in knowing what the part number is on this, I ordered from Beck and Arnley. The parts number is 201-1453. I bought it off of Amazon, and I want to say it was about $12. So, I mean, it worked really good for me, and so I imagine it'll work really good for you. Well, I mean, at least it worked in the sense of getting it back on. It fit perfectly fine. So,
pull out the switch, all three of them come on. The back end looked kind of funny too, but we put it together, and when we got through, well, that's when we noticed that we only had one tail fin. About that time, my wife walked out, and I could see in her eyes that she had her doubts. But she opened the door and said, "Honey, take me for a spin." So we drove uptown just to get the tags, and I headed to ride on down Main Drag. I could hear everybody laughing, blocks around,
with using a wire wheel.
But up there at the courthouse, they didn't laugh, cause to type it up, they took the whole staff. And when they got through, the title weighed 60 pounds. I got it one piece at a time, and it didn't cost me a dime. You'll know it's me when I come through your town. I'm gonna ride around in style.
So what I'm gonna do to save myself a little bit of room for while I'm working, is I'm going to put the manifold onto the block, and I'm gonna just put two of the nuts on there, just kind of keep it all together. On the cost of this machine there, Red Rider. You might say I went right up to the factory and picked it up. It's cheaper that way. What model is it? I think right now it looks really good. It's really starting to come back together. It's starting to come back to life. It looks really good and clean. I'm a little nervous for my next project, which is going to be the carburetor. I have the carburetor. I'll take it off. It's ready to be worked on. I have a carb kit ready to rebuild, but definitely has me nervous. Regardless, it does need to be done. And so this is going to be my next project, but I'm going to wait until I have a good solid 2 days off. This past month I've been working 6 days a week, and I just don't really have the time to be working on such an invasive project. So anyway, this is my next project. Back to the engine. Like I said, it looks good. I'm happy with it. It's really coming back to life, and it just makes me excited to have it all at this point.
Well, that finishes the intake manifold on the Suzuki Samurai engine. It was a really simple and easy task. I really didn't replace many of the parts. The only thing that I did replace was the water temperature sending unit, which I happened to break when removing it. The real purpose of this task was to I just wanted to paint the intake manifold to match the engine block. I didn't want a really shiny fresh coat of paint on the block and then have an old 30 years worth of dust, dirt, and grime sitting on the intake manifold. I didn't really replace any of the parts on the intake manifold, just because it's a really, really easy spot to get to. I could have replaced the thermostat while rebuilding it, but the thermostat looked fine, plus it's just in an easy spot to get to. I could have replaced every single last part on that intake manifold, but I really wanted to get it done. I wanted to get it back on the engine and just move along like I said, it's in such an easy spot to get to that if I do ever have to replace it, I'm not going to be worried about spending 15 minutes to replace parts. So I think that turned out well. I'm really happy with the way that the paint came out. I wish it just kind of came out a little more smooth. I wish it had a smoother surface, a smoother finish. But like I said, that cast aluminum just has like a weird texture to it. It had a weird texture to begin with, so yeah, that weird texture just kind of came through with the paint. But regardless, it did come out looking really good, and I'm really pleased with how it turned out. Just wanted to say thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I really hope that you enjoyed watching it just as much as I enjoyed making it. If you did like this video, please be sure to leave a like, comment on it, let me know that you enjoyed the video. Definitely subscribe to this channel because I'm going to have a lot more videos coming. So thank you so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed it. So just stay tuned for my next project, which is going to be that carburetor.